Hi everyone, welcome back. For those who are new here, my name is Emmy and I am a 2021 graduate from Boston University. I created this channel to document my UX and product design journey as a new grad and share some tips and resources with you all along the way. Today, I'll be redesigning my design portfolio. The design portfolio is crucial if you are looking for a job in the UX and product design world. Most often, a portfolio takes place in form of a personal website that is a collection of work samples and case studies. It's a space to show off what you've accomplished and also show what you can do in the future. While you can code and build your website from scratch, you can also make your life a lot easier by choosing a website builder that doesn't require code at all. This includes platforms like Webflow, Adobe Portfolio, Squarespace, and more. I'll be designing my website in Webflow. And for a little bit of background, whenever I started in design, so my sophomore year of college, I used a website builder called Wix. And this was less for UX and product design work and more for art and graphic design. Whenever I entered my junior year of college, I ended up switching to using Adobe Portfolio because it was A, free with my Adobe student subscription plan, and then two, it was also responsive. And this is whenever I included more case studies and in detail work for UX. Then in my senior year of college, at the beginning, I dabbled in Webflow and used this pre-made template to build out my website. And I actually had my portfolio hosted on Webflow for a couple of months before I ended up switching back to Adobe Portfolio because I needed to make some very quick changes to my portfolio. And I didn't have time to go into Webflow and break down the template and think about like what I needed to change before making those changes. With that said, Webflow does require a little bit of HTML and CSS knowledge. I mean, you don't have to know HTML and CSS through and through, but it's definitely helpful to have because Webflow does use a lot of HTML, CSS terminology. For me, I have like a little bit of HTML and CSS knowledge. I took a class my sophomore year and I was more like fluent then, but I've been kind of like out of practice since then. And so I know a bit of the background, so that's why I'm choosing Webflow, but I'm definitely nowhere near as proficient as I used to be. But just keep that in mind if you are also looking into Webflow. But I know there's a lot of really great tutorials on Webflow on YouTube, lots of great creators. I'll link them down below for the ones that I use whenever building this website from scratch. Now I am transitioning over to Webflow, but instead of using that pre-made template that I used in the past, I'm going to try to build out the portfolio that I designed in Figma. So today's beverage of choice is a cold brew coffee with oat milk cold foam. For those who have not had this combination, I definitely recommend it. For the cold brew, I use Stoke cold brew, which you can find in most of your local grocery stores, and it's fantastic. So grab your coffee or beverage of choice and let's get to it. So good. Here is a little workspace tour for you all. I have my desktop seated in the corner right here, along with this really amazing keyboard I got from Amazon. If you are on TikTok, you might have seen this keyboard before. It's really beautiful. I love like the clicky clack noises that it makes. I use it more for writing and just kind of like casual internet browsing and not really for design, because for design, I just prefer the touchpad that my Mac has rather than using the mouse. I have my laptop right here, so I can just have like dual screens. A lot of pens, Tombow pens, model liners, because I am a big bullet journaler, and some plants. Is anybody else's like half of their working or designing time just looking at Spotify and thinking about what to listen to while you work? Because that's where I am right now. I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one, right? So it's been a few hours and this is what I built up so far. How I started is I went and made like a styles page and just did kind of like a rough document of the different headings and colors, styles, etc. So it could be easier to implement it in my design whenever I'm actually building the website. I also had this design for the website over here in Figma. This is how I wanted it to look, so I just had this as a frame of reference for like the homepage, for example, and then I'm building it out block by block. I also created a page for the project CMS, so how that would look, kind of like a rough draft of that. I also want to have kind of like a little like play section, so where I would categorize all my uncategorized design work and art, and then a little about page. So this is how it is right now. There's a few things that I need to like work out, like I couldn't get the outline text, so I'm trying to figure that out here. I also want to mess around with the arrangement because whenever I go and preview it, it looks like, I don't know why the margins are so large on the sides. And then also there's this like weird underline thing that's been showing up, so I also need to figure out that for the links. But so far so good. It has been a couple of days and I think I'm at a place where my portfolio is pretty set for at the moment, so I am going to give you all a little tour. Here it is, my new portfolio. I am going to refresh the page so you all can see this cool little animation. Bam, there it is. I put in the captions down below a link to a YouTube video that helped me figure out how to do that. And yeah, here it is. I have the homepage. I want to focus bright and center who I am and who, what I do, what I work on. I have a little quick caption of my personal goals and what I currently do and previously did. I am going to show you all a little bit of my previous portfolio that I made in Adobe Portfolio, and that is here. So this is my old portfolio. I use an Adobe Portfolio template. I forgot the name of it, but it's like one of the top ones, and it's pretty basic as far as layout and everything. And another piece of feedback that I got previously is to make my page covers more consistent visually, and that's something that I played around with right here, as you can see, but there are some parts that weren't as visually consistent. This my old about page, also pretty basic, and whenever I was going into Webflow, I wanted to emphasize more of my personal brand, so using that gold, beige, tan and green color scheme, and then also play around a bit with animations. So one of the things that I was really proud of is doing this little green cursor, and this is something that I've been wanting to do for a long time, just like have fun with the cursors and explore how to do that. So I have a little green cursor there, and whenever you scroll over a link, it gets bigger and it also turns gold. So that's cool right there. And then whenever you scroll down, bam, this is actually a bit different than what I showed in that like mid update. I was playing around more with some animations and I was thinking I'd rather have more focus on each individual project rather than be small and stacked in like that two column layout that I had before. So it's kind of scrolls up like you are getting a slide deck, which is cool. And I also made these new profile headers and chose to make them this sort of pastel-y background color scheme going on, so it matches with the rest of my website. And I really like it. I think it looks clean and consistent. And there's a little bit of my footer. Let's stay in touch with links to my LinkedIn, Twitter, YouTube, Notion, blog, and Spotify, because I love making Spotify playlists, and I have different Pantone covers for each of my playlists, which I actually need to update, but a little fun there. Whenever I scroll back up, let's click on one of my pages.
kind of a basic layout. Another thing that I enjoy playing around with is this progress bar up here. I know case studies can be really long sometimes, and something that I really enjoyed looking at other people's portfolios is those progress bars, so you or the user know where you are within the case study. So you can scroll down. I have a little quick synopsis of the duration, role, team, and tools, context, and then I jump right into the content, going from introduction, the user research process, the little MVP that we launched, and then iterations and final redesign. And then this kind of is the same layout for each of my projects that I've done. I also like to link a working Figma prototype for each of my projects, and then some takeaways. Then we have the about page. I also do that similar animation there that I had on the home page. Putting in nice to meet you. I changed up the profile picture a little bit by just adding this cool arc. And then I go into my actual information. I really love the about page because it's a chance to show people that I'm a human, not just a designer, and maybe potentially could relate to some other people as along the way. I really like it whenever I go into other designers' profiles and I can see their about page and see that they're also interested in the same things as me. I think it adds a little personality and fun. So I'm really into those personality tests and quizzes. So I have a little bit of information on that, as well as some of my life goals. Also talk to me about books, love reading, love books, and health and fitness, huge into finding new ways to get active. And as I mentioned, music and podcasts. So that page actually remained largely similar to my old Adobe portfolio page. I just added a few different things up here to make it consistent with that homepage. And then last but not least, I have a link to my resume in the website. So if a hiring manager or recruiter is looking at my portfolio, they have easy access to it there.
To wrap up, some things that I've learned and some advice that I have for people who are redoing their portfolio right now. One, if you already have a portfolio and you are looking to redesign yours, get solid feedback first before you start redesigning it. I personally just accumulated all the feedback that I had gotten about my portfolio for the past year and made a little like master doc and separated it based on like the different pages and like the different topics. So like this is all the feedback that I got for the homepage. This is what the feedback I got for the projects page, about page, and so on. Then I was sure to implement that feedback into the design that I made in Figma. Second, design how you want your portfolio to look before you go into Webflow. You can definitely get a lot of inspiration on some websites like Cofolios, also the awards.com website. Just look up all these different designers and how their portfolios look to get some inspiration and how you want your personal website to reflect your personal brand. If you are designing your portfolio from scratch or from without a template, designing how you want your portfolio to look in Figma or Adobe XD is really important, because if you go into Webflow without a plan or without an idea of how you want your website to look, it can be really overwhelming. So make your life a lot easier by designing it in Figma first. It doesn't have to be perfect, just a rough idea of the styles you want, make a little style guide, the font, the color scheme you're going for, and the general look and feel of, I would suggest, like the home page, the projects page, and your about page. Another tip, whenever you are done designing your portfolio in Figma or Adobe XD, and you are ready to start going into Webflow, build a design system first. I personally created a secret page within my website and made basically the style guide there. So I put in the different heading styles, heading one, heading two, subhead, etc., the fonts, the colors that I want to use throughout the website, and more. This helped speed up the process a lot whenever I was done with it, and then I could start building out the website and provided for visual consistency throughout my portfolio. Overall, I had a really great time working with my portfolio in Webflow, even though there was kind of a learning curve at first. I was kind of overwhelmed and worried. I was like, should I just go back to Adobe Portfolio, play it safe a little bit because there's a lot to learn. But a lot of the YouTube tutorials that I linked down below were very helpful throughout the process. And it was kind of a good challenge too, whenever I was designing my portfolio and I couldn't figure something out. And then I look up the YouTube videos and tutorials, and then I figured out that animation that I really wanted and stuff like that. It was kind of like a cool thing to experience. I was like, wow, I can do this. So I really recommend it if you're looking for a new challenge. And also, I was able to explore my personal brand and how I wanted it to be reflected on my portfolio as well in more depth that I haven't really been able to do before. So I really enjoyed working in Webflow, and I can't wait to get even more feedback on my website. I linked it down below, so if you have any comments, feedback, etc., definitely let me know, and I'll be happy to give it a chat and explore more of how I can communicate my design process and who I am as an individual in a better way. I hope this video helped you out, whether you are considering moving to another platform for your portfolio or thinking about just spicing up and jazzing up your portfolio a little bit. If you have any remaining questions about Webflow or my experience with it, definitely leave them in the comments or shoot me a message, and I'd be happy to chat more about it. Thanks all for watching video number 2, and stay tuned for video number 3. Bye!